Good morning, students, and welcome to today's maths class. So in the previous class, we studied subtraction of numbers with regrouping, correct? So first we saw how to subtract two-digit numbers with regrouping. So what we do first, we arrange the numbers vertically in their place value chart, and then we start subtracting the ones, and then we subtract the tens. Correct. So here we have taken an example of subtract 35 from 52. So to subtract these numbers, first we write them in the place value chart, then we start subtracting ones. So 2 minus 5. We cannot take away 5 from 2. Right. So we cannot take away 5 ones from 2 ones. So what we do? So we borrow 110 from the tens column and add to the ones. So we have 110 plus 2 ones. So that is 10 1, 110 is nothing but 10 ones. So 10 ones plus 2 ones gives you total 12 ones. So now 12 ones minus 5 ones is how much? It is 7 ones. Okay. And then we subtract the tens. Okay. So as 110, so we borrowed 110, correct? So we gave away 110. So that tens column we have 5 10 minus 110, which is 4 tens. Okay. So now we have 4 tens minus 3 tens, which is 110. So we have 52 minus 35 as 17. So 17 here is the difference. 17, that is the answer, is called the difference. Okay, so this is how you subtract two digit numbers with regrouping. Then we saw subtraction of 3 digit numbers with regrouping, or we saw subtraction of 4 digit numbers with regrouping. So first what we did, to find the difference between 7250 and 1328. So what we did, we arranged the numbers vertically in the place value chart, and we started subtracting from 1. So we can't do 0 ones minus 8 ones, so we'll borrow 110 from 10's place. So that becomes 10 ones minus 8, which is 2, and that 5 tens has become 4 tens now. So 4 minus 2 is 2, so we'll write 2 in tens column. And in hundreds place, we have 2 hundreds minus 3 hundreds. We cannot do that. So we'll borrow 1 from thousands. So the 2 hundreds becomes 1200. And the 7000, which is there, becomes 6000. So 12 minus 3 is how much? It is 9. And 6 minus 1 is 5. So the difference is 5922. Okay, then we saw how to do verification of your subtraction. So how do you do verification? We do verification by addition. So what does it mean? So when you subtract two numbers, okay, when you're subtracting two numbers, the larger number is called a minuend. So it is called a minuend, M-I-N-U-E-N-D, okay, and the smaller number is called the subtrahend. Okay, so to find and the answer that you get is called the difference. So for verification, what we do, we add the difference and the subtrahend. Okay, so here in this problem, the difference is 2046. And what is the subtrahend? It is 1754. So we'll add the difference and the subtrahend. So when we do that, we get here 3800. So 3800 is nothing but the minuend here, or the larger number. Correct. So that means your answer is right. So when you add subtrahend and your difference, if you get the minuend, it means that the verification is right. Okay, so this is how you do subtraction of numbers with regrouping and how you do verification. In today's class, we are going to study what is combined addition and subtraction, and also we will see how to do word problems. Okay, so we see, in most of the situations, what you face, practical situations, it involves both addition also and subtraction also. So we know, for example, if you go to a grocery shop to buy some things. So when you buy a number of things, so to find the bill, what you do, you find, you total the amount of things you have bought, correct? So you find the total amount of each item. So each item has a cost. So to find the total amount, you add all the costs of all the items. But sometimes what happened, you don't have the exact change. For example, if your bill is 678, you don't have exactly 678. So what you'll do, you you'll give 1000 rupees to the shopkeeper. So now you need to know how much change you're getting. So you subtract here, 1000 minus 678. So here we used addition also and subtraction also. So mostly in most situation, we need to use both addition and subtraction. Okay. So we know that when we add two or three more numbers, we can do it in any order. Whenever we add in two or more numbers, we can add in any order. But when we have two operations involved, so here we have addition also, subtraction also. So then what you do, you cannot do that in any order. So we need to proceed in the order given in the question. So let's see example. So in the first example, we have 553 plus 218 minus 321. So first what we have, first we have addition. So first we have to do addition only. Okay, you can't do 543 plus 321. You have to do 543 plus 218 only. So when you add the two numbers, you get 761. And then they have told 553 plus 218 minus 321. So what you'll do here, you'll not do 218 minus 321. You will, the addition that you have done, that is 543 plus 218, you got 761. So that from that 761, you'll minus 321. So 761 minus 321 is 440. So the answer for first question is 440. Same way here, 8,540 minus 325 plus 2,347. So first you'll subtract these two numbers and the answer that you get, you'll add it to 2,347. So when you subtract the two numbers, we get 5,415. So then we'll add it to 2,347. So when you add that, you'll get an answer of 7,762. Okay, now here we have 5,894 minus 1,973 minus 875. So we'll subtract the first two numbers first. 5,894 minus 1,973. So when you do that, you get 3,921. Then from 3,921, we'll subtract 875. So when you do the subtraction, you'll get 3046. Okay, so the answer is 3046 there. So this is how you do combined addition and subtraction problems. So let's see the few problems which are there in your textbook. So combined addition and subtraction. Page number 115, exercise 3.4 over here. That is simplify. Okay, so there are four problems. Let's do those problems now. The first problem is 345 plus 423 minus 525. So first question. So first what we'll do, we'll add 345 and 423 first. So first you write it like this in vertically, then add. So 5 plus 3 is 8, 4 plus 4 is 8, and 3 plus 2 is 5. So we get 588. So this 588 minus 525 we will do. When we do that, so 8 minus 5 3, 8 minus 2 is 6, and 5 minus 5 is 0. So the answer for question number A is 63. Okay, 63. Then question B in your textbooks, that is 3425 minus 1418 plus 785. So first we'll subtract 3425 and 1418, and the answer that we get with that, we'll add 785. So first subtraction, so that is 5 minus 8. We cannot do 5 minus 8, so what we'll do, we'll borrow 1 from 2. Okay, we'll borrow 1 from 2. So when you do that, this 2 becomes 1 and this 5 becomes 15. So 15 minus 8 is 77. So we'll write down 7 here. Then 1 minus 1 is 0. 4 minus 4 is 0. And 3 minus 1 is 2. So that is 2007. Now 2007 will add it to 785 over here. Okay, we'll add it to 785. So 2007 plus 785. 7 plus 5 is 12. So we'll carry over 1. 1 plus 8 is 9, so we'll write 9 here. Then 0 plus 7 is 7, and 2 plus 0 is 2. So 2792 is the answer for question number B. Alright, so this is the second question. Then coming to the third question. 9,287 minus 3,185 and 1,240. So first we'll subtract the first two numbers, that is 9,287 minus 3,185. So first we'll do 7 minus 5. How much is 7 minus 5? It is 2. So we'll write down 2. Then 8 minus 8 is 0. 2 minus 1 is 1. And 9 minus 3 is 6. So that is 6,102. So from 6,102, we'll subtract 1,240. Okay, so we'll subtract that like this. So 2 minus 0 is 2. Now we cannot do 0 minus 4. So we'll borrow 1 from this 1. So this 1 becomes 0. Okay, so the 1 becomes 0. And this 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 4 is how much? It is 6. Then 0 minus 2 again we cannot do. So what we'll do? We'll borrow from 6. So 6 becomes 5. And this becomes 10. Okay, it becomes 10. So 10 minus 2 is 8 and 5 minus 1 is 4. So the answer is 4,862. Alright, so that's the answer for question C. Then moving on to question number D. 4,147 minus 2,389 plus 1,290. So first we'll subtract 4,147 minus 2,389. So 7 minus 9 you cannot do, so we'll borrow. So the 4 becomes 3 here. And this becomes 17. So 17 minus 9 is 8. So we write down 8. 3 minus 8 will not be able to do. So we'll borrow 1 again. So this 1 becomes 0 here. And this becomes 13. So 13 minus 8 is 5. 0 minus 3 you can't do. So we'll borrow 1 from 4. So 4 becomes 3. And this 0 becomes 10. Okay, it becomes 10. So 10 minus 3 is 7 and 3 minus 1 is 2. So 1,758. So we'll add 1,758 to 1,290. So when you add that, 8 plus 0, 8. 5 plus 9, 14. So 4, carry over 1. 1 plus 7, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. So write 0 and carry over 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. So the answer is 3,048. Okay, it is 3,048. So this is how you do combined addition and subtraction. However, it is given in the problem, you do it in order. You solve it in order. You cannot change the order of addition or subtraction. So what order is given to you all, you have to follow that order. Alright. So now what we'll do is we'll do number stories. Okay, we'll do number stories. So what are number stories? Number stories are nothing but they are kind of stories that are given on numbers, and on based on those stories they'll ask you to solve and find something, or they'll give you a question for which you have to find a solution. So let's see a few examples. If you are told a school offered Sanskrit and Kannada as second language, out of 1,348 students, 879 opted for Sanskrit. So how many chose Kannada? So there are 1,348 students in a school. From that, 8,079 students took Sanskrit as their second language. So they are asking how many chose Kannada. So to find that, what you do, you subtract the two numbers. So number of students is 1,348. Students opting for Sanskrit is 879. Students opting for Kannada is 1,348 minus 879. So when you subtract the two numbers, you get the answer as 469. So students opting for Kannada is 469. Okay. So the next question. So they are asking, find the number which is 3,152 less than 6,858. So now what is 2 less than 7? You see, 2 less than 7, what you do? You do 7 minus 2, which is 5. So same way to find 3,152 less than 6,858, you will subtract the two numbers. So the first number here is 6,858. The second number is 3,152. So when you subtract the two numbers, you'll get your required number. So your required number is 8 minus 2, 6, 5 minus 5, 0, 8 minus 1, 7, and 6 minus 3, 3. So that is 3706 is your required number. Alright. Now, one more example. So 745 people were traveling in a Shatabdi Express from Bangalore to Chennai. 85 people got in at the first stop. 223 got off at the second stop. So how many people continued the journey in the train? So they're telling 745 people are traveling from Bangalore to Chennai in a train. So 85 people extra got in at the first stop and 223 people got down at the second stop. So they're asking how many continued the journey. So now at the beginning, how many people were there? 745. So number of people traveling in the beginning, 745. Number of people who got in at the first stop is 85. So total number of people after the first stop is 830. So you add 745 and 85, you'll get 830. Then at second stop, number of people who got off at second stop is 223. So remaining people in the train, how will you find out? You will subtract. So 830 minus 223, you will get 607. So 607 are the people remaining in the train. Okay, so this is an example for addition and subtraction combined problems. Alright, so these are number stories. Then moving on to the number stories given in your textbook. So exercise 3.5 on page number 117. So the first five problems, that is, there are 2,830 workers in a company. 1,345 of them are men. How many are women? So let's see how to do it. So number of workers in the company are 2,830. So we'll write that. Then number of men are 1,345. So number of women will be how much? You'll subtract the two numbers. So 2,830 minus 1,345. So when you do that, you cannot do 0 minus 5. So you'll borrow one from tens place. So when you borrow one from tens place, this 3 becomes 2 and the 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5, 5. You can't do 2 minus 4, so you'll borrow 1 again. So this becomes 7 and this becomes 12. Okay, it becomes 12. So 12 minus 4 is 8, 7 minus 3 is 4 and 2 minus 1 is 1. So number of women working in the company is 1,485. Alright, so out of 500 that he had, 5,000 rupees, 5,000 that he had, Rajat spent 3,500 rupees. How much is left with him? So Rajat had 5,000 rupees with him in total. In that he spent 3,500 rupees. So how much money is left with him? So amount Rajat had is 5,000. Amount he spent is 3,500. Amount left with him is 5,000 minus 3,500. Okay. So you will do 5,000 minus 3,500. This is not she, this is he. So cancel this S. Just write he. Okay. So 0 minus 0 will be 0. Then again 0 minus 0 is 0. You can't do 0 minus 5 now. So we'll borrow 1 from this 5. So this 5 becomes 4. And this 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5. And 4 minus 3 is 1. So that is 1500. So how much money is left with Rajat? He is left with 1500 rupees. He is left with 1500 rupees. Okay, now moving on to the third question. When I bought a pressure cooker and a pan for rupees 5280. So total cost of a pressure cooker plus a pan is 5280. So they're telling the cost of the cooker is 4135. They're asking what is the cost of the pan. Okay, so total cost is 5280. Cost of cooker is 4135. So cost of pan will be 5280 minus 4135. So when you subtract that, you'll get an answer of 1145. So this is rupees 1145. Okay, so cost of man is 1145. Then Mitai Wala had stocked 350 kg of sweets, 420 kg of savories during Diwali. If 550 kg was sold out, how much was remaining? So a Mitai Wala had sweets of 350 kg, savory of 420 kg, okay, and from that he sold 550 kg. So they're asking how much was remaining. So weight of sweets is 350, savories is 420, and weight sold will be 350 plus 420 minus 550. So first you'll add 350 plus 420. So when you do that, you'll get 770. Then from 770, you'll subtract the weight he sold out, that is 550 kg. So when you do that, you'll be left with 220 kg. Okay, so the remaining will be 220 kg. Okay, then last problem. Setu has two mango groves. She got 1525 mangoes from one, 3458 mangoes from the other. From those, she sold 3500. So how many mangoes are left with Setu? So Setu has two mango groves. So from one mango grove, she got 1525 mangoes. So number of mangoes from one is 1525. Number of mangoes from the other is 3458. So number of mangoes sold is 3500. So they're asking how many mangoes are left. So to do that, you'll first add 1525 plus 3458, 4458. Then you'll subtract that sum with 3500. Okay, so 1525 plus 3458. So when you do that, you'll have 4983. Then what you'll do, you'll subtract 4983 from 3500. So when you do that, you'll be left with 1483. So number of mangoes left with Setu is 1483. Okay, so this was number stories. Alright, so now question number 6 in your textbooks. Nitin recharged his mobile phone for 300 rupees and 250 rupees during a month. At the end of the month, he had a balance of 70 rupees. How much he had used up? So in 1 month, Nitin recharged his mobile for 300 rupees and 250 rupees. And then they're telling at the end of the month, only 74 rupees were left in his phone. That is, a balance was 74 rupees. So how much he used up? So what you'll do here, first you'll add 300 and 250. And then the answer that you get, you'll subtract 74 from it. Okay, so this you do for homework. Question number 6 is for homework. Alright students, so this was the chapter subtraction. In the next class, we'll start with the next chapter. Alright, thank you. I'll see you all in the next class.